Hi, I'm Nicholas Hampton. I am 14 years old. I love to play football, basketball with my friends. I'm in ROTC high school, normal teenage stuff. And I have sickle cell.
The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention estimates 80,000 Americans are affected by sickle cell disease. Many will need blood transfusions during their treatment.
Hi, I'm Aisha. I'm a sickle cell patient. I have SS.
SS is often referred to as sickle cell anemia. It is commonly the most severe form of the disease.
Sickle cell is a genetic disorder passed off from parents. Kids have no control over it. It affects the red blood cells.
Normal red blood cells carry oxygen freely through the body. Sickle cells get stuck, blocking oxygen from getting to tissues. This causes a deep, gnawing, throbbing pain called a pain crisis.
Imagine a toothache, but in your joints. Like you're the worst toothache you ever had, but it's in your joints, so you can't really get to it.
Someone who doesn't have sickle cell, their red blood cells last about 120 days. Someone with sickle cell, their red blood cells only last about 20 days. Transfusions help by replacing those red blood cells that have died off.
Right now, I'm getting blood transfusions every 3 weeks. Blood donation makes sure that I do not have as many crises.
I got a blood transfusion last month. I'm getting a blood transfusion tomorrow. So it's a big part of my treatment.
African Americans are more carriers for sickle cell disease. Only 1% of African Americans donate blood.
It's 1%. 1% of minorities donate blood. I'm trying to get people like me to donate, minorities to donate, to get that match.
African Americans carry an antigen in their blood that sickle cell patients need.
Antigens are markers on red blood cells. Cells with foreign antigens are often attacked by the body. This can be deadly, but the risk drops with more closely matched blood.
So even though a sickle cell patient can receive blood from anyone, it's better for them to receive it from an African-American, one African-American receiving blood from another African-American.
Well, what if I was your daughter? What if I was your sister? What if I was your aunt? You know, what if I was just your best friend? What would you do? You would want somebody to donate for them.
My name is Isaac Lewin, and I've been donating blood for a few years now. If African-Americans can give blood to other African-Americans, it would help. We all need to look out for each other, you know, as individuals and as a whole race. I would tell all the African Americans to start donating blood. It doesn't take anything but an hour of your time, and it's good. It helps the community. It helps people in need.
Thank you, but also keep giving blood, not only for my benefit, but for other kids' benefits and for other people who need the blood to live perfectly everyday normal lives.
When you see little kids in the hospital needing these transfusions, and then you find African Americans who are willing to donate, the best response is thank you. Don't think about it, just do it.
For more information on donating blood and our sickle cell donor program, call 704-972-4727 or visit cbcc.us.